friend Sam Rashmi Verma. I'm a teacher in DMS Bhopal. I hope you all are fit and fine. So today we will take chapter 4, long and short, of class 3, maths. Let's start the chapter with an interesting short story. It's a story about a girl named Lali. Lali is selling things at her father's shop. A farmer comes to buy rope. Farmer said, "Can you give me 7 arms of rope?" Lali said, "Here is your 7 arms of rope." Lali measured the rope with her arms. Then farmer said, "But this is only 6 arms long." Lali got confused as she also measured correctly. So Lali said, "Why don't you measure your arms with this rope and take 7 times of that length?" What do you think why this happened? Let me give you a clue. Is your father's and mother's arm length is same as that yours? No. That's why the measurement gets wrong here. So the farmer measures his arm with the rope and Lali gives him 7 times that much rope. You can try it yourself by measure your arm and your mother's and father's arm's length and compare it yourself. So let's jump to the other activity. Now let's play a short game. I will show you some picture and you have to guess the answer. This is your first picture. You have to tell in how many steps will Dorji, this boy name is Dorji, cross the road. So you can use your fingers like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we can see here that Dorji will take about 9 steps. As we can see here that Dorji take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 steps. So we can say that Dorji will take about 8 steps. Now our second picture is this. So we can use our finger like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we can conclude that we can place about 7 cups on this table. So we can see here 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 cups can be placed in a line on this table. Now you have to guess how many shirt can be hung on this wire. So we can use our fingers or our hands like this. 1, 2, 3. It's approximately 3, so we can say that we can hang about 3 shirts over this wire. So now we'll see the other activity. Now you can see this scale. I have made this scale myself and you can see the little boxes over there. We will use this scale to measure different objects like this pet stick. We will place the object over here from this starting. So we can see that this matchstick cover 1, 2, 3, 4. Little less than 4 boxes. So we can say that this matchstick is little less than 4 little boxes. And this one boxes represent 1 centimeter. So we can say that this matchstick is little less than 4 centimeter. We can also measure this pen and we have to place this pen on the left starting point and we will now count the number of boxes this covered. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. It is a little more than 13, so we can say that this pen is little more than 13 centimeter. As we can also see here, so this lizard covered about 13 little boxes from 0 to 13. So we can say that this lizard length is 13 centimeter. And this matchstick cover 4 little boxes from 1 to 5. So the length of this matchstick is 4 centimeter long. Now let's start the other activity in which we see how big is our hand. For this activity, you will need an A4 size sheet of your color choice, a scale and a marker. For this activity to begin, you have to put your hand like this on this sheet and trace your hand picture with this marker. Now you will get a picture of your hand like this. We can see here like this. After this, we can easily tell the length of our fingers by using the scale. So we can see, we will start it from 0 centimeter and count the numbers. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we can here write that our index finger is 8 centimeter long. Do you love solving riddles? Let's solve a short riddle. Aunt Ghibli has to reach the greens as she is very hungry. She is looking for the shortest route. Would you like to help her? How will you help her? Let me give you a clue. Which thing is required to measure the length? Yes, a centimeter scale, which I hope you all have in your geometry box. So we will use this scale to find the length of all the roads. Like this, we will start it from 0 centimeter. Road A is 8 centimeter and this road crosses here, so we have to measure it this also 8 centimeter and 6 centimeter. Now we will add 8 centimeter and 6 centimeter, this is 14 centimeter. So road A is 14 centimeter long. We'll measure road B, road C and road D and easily compare the length of all the roads and tell Ghibli which road she should take. So let's jump to the other activity. Do you know how long a meter is? Let's see by making a meter rope. You must have seen shopkeepers measuring clothes with a meter rod. So today we will make a meter ribbon ourselves. For this you will need a marker, a ribbon and a meter scale. I don't have a meter scale, so I made it myself. First of all, you have to make a knot like this from the starting point of this ribbon. Keep the meter scale with this ribbon where the other end lies of the meter scale. Mark it with the help of this marker and make a knot here too, like this. The distance between these two knots is 1 meter. So your 1 meter ribbon is ready, and you will easily can measure the all the objects around you and can easily conclude which object is less than 1 meter and which object is more than 1 meter. So we can conclude that 1 meter has 100 centimeters. Apart from centimeter or meter, there is another unit called kilometer. It is a bigger unit. It is used to measure the long distances. 1000 ribbons like this make 1 kilometer. So it is a bigger unit. It is used to measure the long distances, like distance from your home to school, distance of your playground and many more. Now let's do another activity to know what we have learned today. We have to match each picture with its approximate length. In first picture, we can see length of an earthworm. The length of an earthworm is very small, and for this, centimeter scale would be more appropriate and easy. So here we can see 10 centimeter and 1 centimeter. These are small units. 1 centimeter is very short for the length of an earthworm. So, the length of an earthworm would be 10 cm. Height of a child. You can also measure your height and know this. The more appropriate unit to measure the height of a child is in meters. And here we can see 5 meters and 1 meter. 5 meter is too long for a child's height. So this should be 1 meter. Next, width of a fingernail is about 1 centimeter. So we will match this with 1 centimeter. Next, the length of a sari. You have seen in shops that shopkeeper measure the length of saris by meter rope. So the length of a sari will be 5 meters long. Last, distance from home to school. As we have discussed earlier that long distance are measured in kilometers. So this is a long distance and that's why we use kilometer scale for measuring this. We will match this with 2 kilometers. Last, distance from home to school. As we have discussed earlier that long distances are measured in kilometers. So, this is a long distance and that's why we use kilometer scale for measuring this distance. So, we will match this with 2 kilometers. So, in this next picture, we have matched all the pictures with their measurements. We have learned many things related to measurement. We have learned that there are different units to measure objects. I wish we will meet again with an interesting topic like today. So for now, bye and take care.